Welcome back to this edition of The Lead. I'm Samantha Narson. Let's get started. This week, we're looking at leveling the playing field with the latest news about COVID vaccines. UF will be taking part in Moderna's new coronavirus vaccine study. Students between the age of 18 and 26 will be able to participate. The study will test whether or not this vaccine can prevent spread. The tested individuals cannot have previously contracted the virus or been administered a COVID-19 vaccine. About 1,000 participants will be chosen. To view the complete story and for any of your other news needs, check out WUFT.org. Staples and Office Depot are laminating COVID vaccination cards for free. Office Depot and Office Max stores nationwide are running the special through July 25th. Staples' offer will last until May 1st. Both companies require a coupon code that can be used in store. Laminations are done after both Pfizer or Moderna doses or one Johnson & Johnson vaccine dose. The CDC recommends keeping the card and even taking a personal photo as a backup copy. Shan's patient care assistant, Clara Vital, says she laminated her card to keep it with her at all times.
I just felt like, you know, it would be fun to have it as a keepsake, and it would also be really cool just to, like, bring it around. See, I always bring it in my purse.
While your vaccination card might now be picture perfect, experts say not to show these cards online. The Better Business Bureau and Federal Trade Commission recommend sharing your vaccination sticker to social media instead. Today, COVID-19 vaccines are available to more Floridians than ever before. The Lead's Valeria Antonchuk looks into what this means for North Central Florida.
All Floridians 16 and older are eligible to receive COVID-19 vaccinations today. UF Health is working in collaboration with the Florida Department of Health in Alachua County to vaccinate the North Central Florida community. UF Health Dr. Michael Lizardo says UF Health plans to administer 20,000 vaccines weekly for the next 6 weeks, with hundreds of volunteers available to administer vaccines at Ben Hill Griffin Stadium.
Made an unprecedented number of vaccine appointments. So we have 5,000 that are available on Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and Saturday of next week. And we plan to do 20,000 vaccinations per week for the next 6 weeks. So we have that access available because of the association and the great collaboration with the athletic department here at UF.
Lizardo says the extended eligibility is an important step in pandemic response, as the majority of spread comes from younger people.
3 out of 4 cases are spread by somebody in their 20s, 30s, and 40s. And once we started vaccinating that group, you're going to see a big drop in the numbers of cases that we get in the county, in the region, in North Central Florida, rest of the state and our country as well. So that's the key thing. The way to end this epidemic, the way we get back to normal, is to start vaccinating people of all ages.
Lizardo says 9,400 spots were filled in the first 24 hours. He says this vaccine rollout will be influential in determining the timeline of this pandemic.
April is the pivotal month. If we do a good job vaccinating people, if people don't delay, if we just get this all done as soon as it's available and as soon as possible, and it will be available, if we do that, this can end in early summer. This can end as early as June. And if that's the case, we start working back to normal, start peeling back a lot of these restrictions.
He says the Pfizer vaccine is currently being administered, though they plan to incorporate Johnson & Johnson doses when the supply becomes available. UF students and employees can make their vaccine appointments with the Alachua County Health Department through the One.UF portal. Valeria Antonchuk, The Lead.
Gender-based inequalities are a prevalent issue in sports. The Lead's Elizabeth Biro looks into this issue and how female athletes are advocating for change.
Female athletes have taken the world of sports by storm, acquiring Olympic medals, World Cups, and various other noteworthy awards. However, these accomplishments have not been met with equality. Women are still paid less than their male counterparts despite their accomplishments. There's also been increasing awareness surrounding the lack of proper equipment and resources for female athletes. Megan Rapinoe, who plays center forward for the United States women's soccer team, has been a continuous advocate of equal pay for female athletes. Despite several World Cup victories and fan favoritism of the women's team, the men still make more. Rapinoe has brought this argument to Congress and serves as a figurehead for women in all sports. A legal battle is underway that would help to bridge this gap. Gender inequality is also an issue for many college athletes. After several images were released on social media depicting the disparities in equipment between male and female NCAA basketball players, weight rooms, and other resources, people began to realize how large the differences truly were. Men received large facilities of exercise equipment, while women were only given a few hand weights. Additionally, men's teams had greater food options and superior coronavirus testing measures. The NCAA now plans to help alleviate frustrations by aiming to equalize resources. Until athletes and their fans see that change happen, they will continue to advocate for change. Everyone may know that April showers bring May flowers, but April also brings a celestial soiree. Here is everything you need to know about the April Lyrids, 2021's Meteor Shower Spectacular. Beginning on April 16th, the Lyrids meteor shower will soar across the night sky. This is a natural phenomena you will want a front row seat for. The Lyrids will be visible from roughly April 16th to April 25th, with the cosmic dance expected to hit its peak visibility on April 22nd in the Northern Hemisphere.
That's it for this edition of The Lead. Thanks for watching. Be sure to tune in on Wednesday for our next episode. I'm Samantha Narson. Have a great week.